Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, in this video, we'll find the expression for acceleration due to gravity at certain latitude on the surface of Earth. Friends, let us find the expression for the acceleration due to gravity at certain latitude. I have Earth like this, and this is the center. So obviously this is the radius. And this is the equator, great circle, greatest circle, and this is the pole, this is the pole, obviously north pole, south pole, and this is the equatorial plane. Now, when the object is taken from or kept at different locations on the planet, that is at different latitudes, here the value of g and here the value of g, or here the value of g, or at any other location, that will change. That way, to find the general expression for acceleration due to gravity at certain latitude, suppose this, that this is a point on the globe at latitude angle is plus lambda. And we have to find the g at this point, and that g at this point is g lambda, and this is what you have to find. When you the point is here, this is lambda is zero. So for equator, lambda is zero, and for pole, this lambda is equal to 90 degree. This is 90. So this is the Earth, and this the radius is r. This is the radius of the Earth, r. This is also R, but you must note in mind, take in mind that this R is the radius of equator, and this R is the radius of the pole. The radius of equatorial radius and the polar radius are not same. The equatorial radius is always greater than the polar radius. The Earth is bulging, so because of its spin motion, it bulges. So the radius here is less here. With what it is spinning? It is spinning with angular velocity omega. Now, as the sphere is spinning, spheroid is spinning, so every point on the planet is also spinning with the same omega. So this will also spin, and it will follow a circular path on the surface of the Earth. So when this object rotates, this point also performs circular motion on its surface. Now, when I want to find the expression for acceleration due to gravity at this point, then I have to draw a few things that I have to find the net force acting on this, basically. And this is R, this is also R, and this radius is R. If this is lambda, this will be lambda, and this is R cos of lambda. So the radius of this circle is R cos lambda, in which the object is spinning. Now, because it is spinning like that, there will be some centrifugal force will act in this direction. That is m omega square r, r means r cos lambda. This is the centrifugal force that we, this point is this object is subjected to, and because the Earth is there, it will pull it towards itself with certain acceleration. Suppose that is the acceleration due to gravity on the surface of the Earth, which is g. In general, I have to find the resultant of these two. And that though it is very, very small, and this is, so it is nearly towards the center, but not exactly towards the center. But the resultant is the G lambda, G effective, you have to find. Now, G effective, which is G lambda, I have to find. Now, the resultant I have to find, if this is lambda, this will be lambda, and this is 180 minus lambda, 180 minus lambda. So I have got situation like this, G over here and M omega square R is here, obviously R cos lambda, but this omega square M is considered because centrifugal force, but I want only the net acceleration, so I will not consider this mass, only I will consider centrifugal acceleration. The resultant I have to find, something like that, that is my G of lambda. Now, the addition and the angle between them comes out to be 180 minus lambda. And I have to find the G lambda, which comes out to be from parallelogram law. This is G square plus omega square R cos lambda square plus 2A and this one. Cos of 180 minus lambda. Okay, what I'm doing is this, suppose this is a vector, this is b vector, a square plus b square plus 2ab cos of this angle 180 minus theta. Okay, and under root, and under root, this comes out to be g square plus omega 4 r square cos square lambda plus whatever this is, 180 minus lambda is 180 minus theta is minus 180 minus theta is minus of cos theta, so this will become like minus here, minus of cos theta, so it becomes 2g omega square r cos square lambda, and the whole power is half. Now I will put this, because this omega is very small, because omega is very small, so omega power 4 can be tends to 0, so this term will cancel, and we are left with g lambda, which is equal to g square, you can see here g square, and minus of this value, minus 2g omega square r cos square lambda, and the whole power is half. Because omega is small and omega square is very, very small, very, very small, and therefore I can use binomial expansion, that means 1 plus x to the power n. If that x is very, very small, less than 1, then much less than 1, then the expression can be written as 1 plus nx. So in this situation, because this is, I consider this okay, this format, then I will consider g square out from here, and I am getting g here, and 1 minus g is over there, 2 omega square r cos square lambda divided by g to the power half. Now, because this omega is very, very small, this 1 minus x to the power n, so it will be 1 minus x to the power n, implies it is 1 minus nx. This is my x, I can think of this as x, this is my n, so I just multiply, I'm getting g minus 2 omega square r cos square lambda by g into n is half. These two and these two will cancel, and this I will multiply again inside, this will go inside, g minus g will multiply here, g will cancel, omega square r cos square lambda. This is the final expression. So what I'm getting here is that g lambda comes out to be g minus omega square r cos square lambda. This is the final expression. Okay, thank you.